Access to energy is vital for socioeconomic development. Every sector requires it, and critical services need it to function well. Despite this, around 110 million people living in urban areas across Africa lack access to grid electricity, and those that do have access experience frequent power outages. So how can we make this critical infrastructure more accessible and reliable? By focusing on further building up an area that Africa is already rich in, renewable energy sources. Across Africa, accessing energy in urban areas can be costly and unreliable. When it comes to people living in informal settlements, the picture is even more complicated. In sub-Saharan Africa, for example, around 55% of all people in urban areas live in slums, many of whom either don't have electricity or have illegal and potentially dangerous connections. Sub-Saharan Africa is also one of the fastest urbanizing regions in the world, and with more urbanization comes even more strain on already fragile energy networks.
Most countries in Africa, with a few exceptions, I must add, are developing, and most cities have a problem that is not unique to one country. And the problems are generally associated with urbanization. When it comes to the energy infrastructure, we know from our own case studies here in Sierra Leone that we have a lot of challenges with capacity, with commercial losses, with technical losses. And the more people that come into the cities, the more strain they put on the energy infrastructure. Most cities currently have power outages. And the challenge is not just to the individual at home. Think about hospitals, schools, businesses, water supply. So getting power into slum communities is really helpful and improves living conditions. Accessibility to power actually improves wealth outcomes. And in the past, we've used generators and kerosene, but that really doesn't help us because at the end of the day, the pollution that comes from those very toxic equipment actually can cause greater harm. If there's a technology there that makes a difference, we need to use it. Why now? Because we are now in a place where we understand that renewable energy works best for us. And I say it works best for the African continent because we have a lot of resources.
For areas that don't already have traditional energy infrastructure in place, a renewable solution is less expensive to build and run and could create new jobs. But developing such solutions still requires a lot of capital upfront and is not without its challenges.
One of the key things that we see in all governments, pretty much everywhere, is the silo effect of ministries and the departments. So integrating across sectors and breaking down those silos is one of the key things that will enable renewable energy to be deployed faster. But also taking into consideration things that you might not think about, for example, land use planning. So even if it's just around the sprawling, how you actually build up the density of a city, that will affect your ability to deploy renewable energy in a faster way. Actually, renewable energy really lends itself to a networked approach. Off-grid or connected, you can build it up in a scalable, flexible way. I think it's also interesting because we have examples of where, by looking at it in terms of networks, you can bundle parts of the network up according to whether they're attractive to private investors. Other opportunities, for example, public-private partnerships are key to drawing in private investors around renewable energy. And so, you know, governments should make sure that they have the policies and platforms ready to support those types of investments going forward. Last but not least, there's the type of investment models that lend themselves well to this type of context. And these are a business pay-as-you-go and a consumer pay-as-you-go. One of the challenges we see around energy infrastructure in general is that many consumers struggle to pay their bills when the period is too far spaced. So pay-as-you-go enables you to make smaller incremental payments. It actually benefits the investors in many ways because they can see the cash flow much more readily. So in an uncertain environment, it gives them a different way of looking at how their investment is coming in.
Such an approach can be an attractive incentive to investors who can quickly start to see a solid and steady return on their investment. What's more, the investments in renewable energy could help expand existing grid capacities, lower carbon emissions, and reduce reliance on fossil fuels, benefiting both the environment as well as the health and well-being of people.